Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and this is the first episode to create Switchable Grid using Vue JS. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss out my new tutorials. So, to begin the course, you can open my GitHub account. I have provided this link in the description below. Once you are in this repository, you should see two folders over here, End and Start. You can use this End folder if you want to see the end result of our site, which is this one. But if you want to follow along with me, you can use this Start folder. Now, let's clone this repository, so click on code and copy this link. Then on desktop, you can create a new folder and call it Vue. You can then open that folder in your text editor. In my case, I'm using Visual Studio Code. So I go to File, Open Folder, Desktop, and select that folder. Then to open the terminal, you can click on View and Terminal. Now to clone the project, you can type git clone and paste the link that you have copied. Navigate to the start folder. So over here, you can type cd space Vue and tab, then cd space start. Now, to add the node module, you can write npm install. To run the project, you can use npm run serve. You can then press Ctrl and click on this link to view the project. And you should see the site with static content. Great. Now, let's quickly check the code before we check the demo. So open your text editor, click on source, and we got our main app, which is app.vue. So here we have added a child component product, which is imported from this components folder. And in this product component, we have all our static HTML code. We'll work mostly on this component, and we'll also add dynamic data using Axios. All styles are added under this main.js, which is importing main.css from assets and CSS folder. Now, let's quickly check the demo, and then we will wrap up this course by adding one static list item to make sure everything is good to proceed. So, this is the demo of our site, which we will be working in our upcoming session. This is a very simple site. We should see the grid layout by default, but if we click on this list button, it should show the list layout. While we are on this list layout, and if we click on this grid button, is to show the grid layout. Now, before I wrap up this course, let's add one static list item to check everything is fine. So, open your product component, and in this list view, first you can remove this display none. I will then copy this li. Add the title and content. Once done, you can check the site and we can see our new list item. Great. It seems everything is good to go. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll show dynamic data using Axios. We will also resolve course issue because our site is hosted locally and our data is hosted at other domain. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.